film. Oh, no, it's not. Yeah. It's the Jenna Haze show.
It's the Jenna Haze show
taking
is
over.
What it is.
That's right.
Tell me when, Joe.
15 seconds.
One.
I'm going to make sure I hit record, guys.
Which is about how long I would last with Jenna Haze. She's like, he wouldn't even last that long.
You're giving yourself a lot of credit, aren't you, old man?
Joe, you ready? All
right, we're ready, so I'm going to just play the intro.
That's
and then
exactly what you were thinking, wasn't it? It's like I was in your head.
Special podcast, basically.
Yes.
All right, you got it.
How you like that? Kindly state your name.
It's Thom and Jeff.
Well, I think these guys are pretty darn dope. Dope.
Check for the sound. What? Notice. They're high, so this will be a good show.
Yeah. The Thom and Jeff Show and the 3Dub Network proudly present podcast number 299, the Porn Star Edition. Welcome, Jenna Haze.
Hey! Hey.
This Hello is actually 298.
There. Yeah, sorry.
That's all right.
Way to go. Way to go, asshole.
Can't even count anymore. See what happens when you put a porn star in front of me?
We were talking to Jenna right before we started, and we were saying how this is uncensored, so you can say anything. Here's an example. You dumb motherfucker. See? You can say whatever you want.
That's fucking awesome.
There you go.
Hey,
all
right.
That's a new record. Yeah. That is a new record.
We've had radio people in here before, like Favaz, who's a legendary radio guy here in town and our friend. And he was like, just because I can cuss doesn't mean I'm 7 minutes in. He said fuck for the first time. And then it was on after that. So
yeah, when I usually do radio interviews, I'm having to watch what I say because fuck is usually right in every sentence.
Still
I
weird
say
to even say it right now, isn't it?
It
is almost kind of weird.
I'm at a radio show and I'm always like walking on eggshells trying not to say
don't
you know,
worry
the words
about
that
it
I'm not supposed to say.
Don't. What's your favorite cuss word?
Fuck.
Say it again.
Fuck.
There you go. There you go. So you're in town over at the Hustler Club.
I am.
All weekend long.
I am, and I have not been here in, gosh, 7-8 years.
We've
now
missed you.
Wow, you were just a pup then last time you were here.
So Ballpark Village wasn't here yet.
I was a beginning dancer. I hadn't, you know, I had just began my feature dancing career, and now I've been doing it for like 9 years now.
Wow. So, and what has changed about the feature dancer industry in the last 7-8 years, whatever?
I mean, it's pretty much the same, just the different girls, you know?
Yeah. Still a lot of Motley Crue songs. I mean, really?
Yes, if I ever have to hear Girls, Girls, Girls again.
Oh, my goodness, Scotty.
Yes.
You know what I'm getting at, right?
Oh, the Dirty Diana?
Yeah. Can you give her a snippet of it?
We can.
Will you put headphones on just real fast? You don't have to talk. This is going to be the new big Gentleman's Club song right here.
I got to find it. Hold on.
How many times did that do in your
life? Oh, bitches.
So
While he's looking for it.
Hustler Club is on
94 and Wolfram.
No, wait, that's Ballyhoo.
It's on Bunkum.
5420 Bunkum Road in Washington Park.
I know. I haven't been here in years, and I know.
Yeah. You got it written down somewhere, though, don't you? Is it? Did you find it?
Yeah, I just got to pull the cable.
All right.
You're performing
tonight.
Tonight.
Yeah, tonight I have one show at 11, and then tomorrow at 11 and 2 a.m.
Don't start it yet, Scott.
And 11 and 2 a.m. on
Saturday.
You're
right in front of a camera. Take a step to your...
And after each show, I'll be offering 8x10s, autographs, and pictures with me.
Can people bring their stuff with them? Like, if you got your... Like, I have my collection of Jenna Haze stuff. I can bring it up.
You can bring that.
Thank you.
I will sign it.
Thank you.
All right, Scotty, tell me when you're ready. We're going to have Blazer Joss as a professional bring on Jenna Haze.
Okay.
Like she's coming up on stage. You don't have to do anything. Just he's going to bring you on, and then he's going to hit the song. This is going to be the greatest freaking strip club song ever since Girls, Girls, Girls. You know the song Dirty Diana by Michael Jackson?
Like, I'm sure I've heard it.
So he's a white female that used to sing in the 80s?
I know who Michael Jackson is, Philly. I'm just not sure if I exactly remember that song.
Dirty Diana. Well, there's a band, an incredible band called Shaman's Harvest, who redid the song.
Okay.
This is a little snippet.
Are you ready? Okay, Josh, bring her on.
Ladies and gentlemen, I need you to put your hands together and welcome multi-AVN Award winner to the Hustler Feature Stage. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jenna Haze.
You're always on.
Oh, no. I'm hard.
From Josh, right?
No.
Never make me stare, so take your weight off.
I know your
every move. Oh, it gets better.
All right, now get up and dance.
Yeah.
You seduce every man, this time you won't seduce me. She's saying that
This song could make you some money, couldn't it?
It's a good song. Yeah.
Scotty's a studio producer. Right?
Pretty good.
Yeah. Okay, that's good. Thank you, Scotty.
And it is a perfect
Sorry.
Song.
What's that?
It's a perfect song.
It hasn't been released yet, though, right?
No. Well, just what I did, so they're probably going to be suing us here
right.
soon.
I've been waiting on it forever.
Josh asks me every time he's here, is that fucking song ready to be released yet?
You know how many people request it, though? That's the problem.
That's awesome.
So now you're retired. You're no longer doing films.
I am. I'm retired from performing on films, but I direct and produce for my company.
How was the last go around? Did you make a big... big whole production out of it, or was
no,
it?
No,
did you know it was your last one?
I just took the words right out of my mouth.
Well,
yeah.
The last couple years that I was performing, I knew it was coming. I kept doing it less and less and less. I was having less, you know, fun, and it was just getting where I just didn't want to do it anymore. Like
it was like,
out,
it was
I just
like
didn't
a job.
Want to do it anymore.
It turned into a job
it was,
almost,
I mean,
right?
It's always been a job. Come yeah. on, let's be real.
Right. Well, I don't know. some porn stars say they love it. Some say it's a job. I don't know. Go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead. I'm buying it, aren't I? Yeah.
But yeah, I knew I was just over it. You know yeah. what I mean? And that's when I started my company and started to, you know, put more effort into producing and directing and stuff like that. And so like the last like year to 2 years, I was very rarely shooting. I would shoot like one scene every couple months or every few months, you know, and every time I did it, I was like, I don't want to do this. I'd rather be behind the camera. I don't want to be in front of the camera anymore.
Right.
So, I actually didn't know. I just, one day I shot a scene in April of 2011 and I was like, That's done.
Huh.
I can't do it again.
You think it was better for that scene and better for you mentally that you didn't know that was your last scene? Or did it matter, really?
I mean, I don't think it would have mattered. I mean, I'm just done. I was mentally not there. Like, I've known for the last, you know, last 2 years that I was shooting every time I shot a scene, I was just like,
right.
just not there. You know, my head would be thinking about, like, my laundry and, like, yeah, yeah. my errands and things like that.
As there's cock swinging all over.
So I was going to say, it'd be weird to be like, okay, is the last one.
Right, here I go. Last one on film.
Fuck, I forgot to add the fabric softener.
it would be coming for a long time.
Do I have jeans ready for the weekend? I don't know.
So I just waited.
I have to make soup when I get home.
Oh God!
I just shot that scene and then like waited a while and realized I was never going to shoot another one. So then finally I was like, I might as well announce this.
Right.
That I'm not going to be doing this anymore because people were like, when's your next movie? When are you going to perform again?
Now those and really ardent like, fans yeah. that follow you and get everything that you put, were they obviously they were upset, right?
Some people are bummed, yeah. but I feel like my true fans who know that this is what's best for me, you know. They will keep supporting me, and they do. Yeah. You know, I keep dancing. I love to dance and tour. That's so much fun.
It keeps you in shape, I would imagine.
I'm not gonna stop that for a long time. I'm a performer. I love being on stage. I love dancing, and I love music. So it's just kind of a really good job.
It's not like you can't find anything that she's ever done.
That's what I was thinking. It's kind of like a band with music. If they break up, you could still get their CD or listen to their songs. There's still stuff out there that you can
watch. 10 years of material there. Like,
right.
How many movies do you know exactly?
You know what? I don't know because... every time you do a movie for somebody, they take it and they will put it in like 7 to 8 to 12 to 20 mm-hmm. compilations. So like I look at like a list online. I've looked at one that says like all my movies and I'm like, there's no.
I wasn't in that. I wasn't in that. Yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't in that movie. I wasn't in that movie because they just take it and just redo it. I mean, so
does that screw you money wise then, or is that already understood that you knew they were going to do that?
Well, that's one of those things that, like, when I first started in the business, I didn't know that they did that, you know? And
right.
so I started shooting for everybody for, like, a while before I signed my contract. And then when I eventually signed my contract, I realized, oh, these people are making compilations out of mm-hmm. me. They're, you know, taking what they paid me for once and turning it into 5, 6, 7. But, hey, now I'm a producer and I can do that.
Yeah, yeah, turn the tables, right?
I can do
right?
that to these girls. No.
Generation X Studios.
Yes, Generation X Studios.
Oh, yeah, we were talking about before we started. It was JennaHaze.com, but things are changing website-wise.
Yes, my adult website used to be JennaHaze.com, but I changed it to JennaXStudios.com to reflect the fact that it's my company now. I'm behind the camera now. I've got all kinds of super hot girls.
Yeah.
You know, that I'm shooting and stuff like that are up there from all the movies that I've shot. I've shot 12 or 13 movies of my company.
Wow, so, nice. Are you literally behind the camera?
I stand behind the cameraman as he moves around. The camera's heavy.
And you're,
I can't hold
yeah,
it.
You're
teeny,
tiny. You're less than 6 foot. I know that for sure.
Tiny. I'm 5 foot three.
Oh my! And it's, well, I've never seen you standing up before, so I.
Really, that was uncalled
for. That was a little funny. Come on, that was funny.
Get him, Jenna! Get him, Jenna!
Oh, time for an ass kicking on video.
Turn her back on me.
So, anyways, yeah, so my website is now going to have everybody that I've directed and stuff like that. So it's genxstudios.com. And it's really, the new design is awesome. It's really great. It's easy. It's really glossy, very magazine looking.
We're looking for a new web guy. And so
I'm
if you have.
We're looking for a new producer, too.
I'm going to take genxstudios.com and make it like more of a mainstream site where you can see like my tour schedule. Pictures of me, like a bio, and it's also going to have merchandise of me, which I've never done before other than selling like 8x10s and things
sure.
on the road.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I'm going to have like t-shirts and special things that I've worn in movies that you can buy and all that stuff. So
how long do you say you've been dancing now? For 8 years?
I've been dancing for, I've started dancing 2 years after I got in the business. So
you started at 19, right?
Yeah.
So it's.
And I'm 30 now. Whoa.
Hey, I'm 38.
Yeah, today. Today's his actual birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
I remember being 30.
You remember being 30? Hey?
15 years ago.
Surprised you remember that.
Awesome. Barely. There was a point fest on my 30th birthday.
Was it fun for you when you first started, or was it always just a job?
Well, I mean, I got in the business because I was tired of being poor and working jobs waitressing and not making any money, and I was already having sex with people. And so when it got offered to me to do it on camera and have people tested and it'd be like a much more safe like
environment.
I was just like, all right, let's go for it. So I mean I've had fun on sets, but it's not like sex off camera.
Right, yeah.
You know, I mean, and getting in the business and doing scenes on camera has made like me realize how much like sex off camera is much more intimate.
So it's actually helped your helped your private sex life.
Yeah. And my sex life now is wilder and crazier than it's ever been. I
can't believe it.
Yeah.
I'm not going to.
Because that one scene, there's just no way.
I mean,
she could do more than that one thing.
When she
remember?
Did that one thing
with
that
the deal
one,
and the
it
thing.
Went all over the place.
Right.
And next thing you know, there's
so
napping.
Silly.
I know. We're stupid. We're dumb. We really are. Do we know like times and days and everything
sure,
over there?
Sure. Gave my, I think it's 11 and 2.
11 and 2?
Tomorrow and Saturday, Friday and Saturday. And then tonight, one show at 11.
Right on. Okay.
And then in between shows, I'll be offering, you know,
oh, that,
8x10s and autographs and pictures with me.
One of the reasons why I asked how long you'd been dancing, I remember years ago, and Tom's really, really big into the gentlemen's clubs and porn stars and stuff like that.
Can't help it.
Yeah. And I remember
well, I mean,
back in the day.
I have to jerk off a lot.
Right.
I mean, come on.
Appreciate that visual. Back in the day, it used to be that. The girl would stand there and you go up and stand next to her and you get a Polaroid
yeah,
taken.
That's what I do.
You still do that now?
I do that. A lot of girls have switched to having like the digital camera and the digital printer. But when you have a big line, which I have a lot, it's
yeah, you do.
It's hard to like just to sit there and like have the camera. What if the camera dies or what if the printer gets jammed? You have to have a plug for the printer. And I'm kind of like nostalgic. I like Polaroids. I like instant gratification.
Okay, this is stupid to say this, but I didn't even know you could still get Polaroid cameras
well,
and Polaroid
make,
film.
They make a camera called Fuji Instax now that's just like it, and except
really?
For it's like wider and it's even better. You can sign
so it's
the
a
bottom.
Basic idea and everything.
Yeah, and wow. It's good because there's like a little area to sign at the bottom, and it's just nice.
Now that you got your own production company, what are you looking for new girls?
Or guys.
Well, I've actually haven't been directing that much. I just started directing again last month with my newest projects. I'm working on two different movies right now. I just scope out like the websites. I go on the agency websites. I go on Twitter. I see who people are talking about. I follow like everybody in the business just so I can see like the girls' pictures. Because you'll see pictures on a girl's on the website for the agency, and of course they look amazing on the
sure.
website.
Yeah.
But you want to see those Twitter pictures because that's going to tell you whether the
exactly
girl is really hot or
right.
not.
Yeah.
You know, so I check them out that way, and I just find girls I really like. Right now, the latest girl that I've shot a couple times is Skin Diamond. She's phenomenal.
I'm ready this.
Now he has entertainment
she
for the
phenomenal.
Evening. Good. Okay.
She actually just did a scene in my last movie that came out, Meow 2.
Meow 2. I was waiting for the sequel of that
for
one.
Best. Oh, girl.
We're looking.
You're so sarcastic.
No,
it's
I'm
awesome.
Not at all. Is that her up there on the TV?
Yeah, she's awesome.
Holy cow, she is hot.
She's super smoking, and she just started feature dancing, so hopefully she'll come out here.
What do you tell to the girls first time around? What's the best piece of advice?
Well, I really like to get people just really being into each other and natural as possible, so I usually give them like a whole speech before, and then I let them kind of go. I rarely try to interject.
And that speech goes something like what?
Wow.
I mean, it depends on what kind of scene I want.
Holy
you know?
Cow, look at her.
Holy.
Yeah, she's smoking.
Wow.
I just shot her in a like S&M themed scene the other day too. For one of my new movies.
You have a obviously you don't, but not a big deal if girls have tattoos.
You know, I don't have any tattoos.
Really?
I have no tattoos. I don't have any piercings. I had my tongue done and my belly button done when I was a teenager, but I took them both out when I was 16. I like them on certain girls, but other girls, like you'll see a girl and they'll be like, oh man, you are so hot and you just ruined yourself with that terrible tattoo.
Well, and also,
but like skin looks hot with all those tattoos, but like other girls, if there's a girl with bad tattoos, I won't shoot her.
Right, and I think it's also the amount of tattoos on girls in this particular industry. It can get a little overboard.
It
as
is,
well.
And I mean, there's niches for that. You know, one of my oldest friends in the business is Joanna Angel, and that's her niche is like the Burning Angel girls, which is like the suicide.
Right, yeah, suicide girls, yeah.
She has all those girls that look like that and that kind of niche filled. But I borrow girls from her movies. That's where I got skin. I was like, I have to shoot that girl. I have to shoot
now,
that
do you,
girl.
Now, do you come up, getting back to the directing and the filmmaking that you're going to do and that you have done in your own company, do you come up with storylines and everything too? Do you write the movies or do you just have somebody else do that?
I don't shoot features.
Oh, you
so
don't?
I don't?
Okay.
No, I don't believe that people want to see acting in their porn.
You are absolutely.
Oh, my God. Yes.
So I don't shoot
that. A visionary.
The only acting
coach,
that
pay attention.
The only acting that should be in porn is she's acting like she likes that penis in her butt. That's the only acting,
exactly.
Really.
Exactly.
Yeah. We're right
no,
there.
I usually shoot, if there's any kind of little mini setups, I usually shoot all sex, which is just straight to the point. They'll
God
be a girl
love
teasing,
yeah.
Or like I'll be talking to the girl and it'll go right into it. Or I'll do like little mini setups where they'll be like that are called like vignettes. Uh-huh. And
we know what they're called. Oh yes, we do.
Okay, well, some people don't know. Yeah. So I'll do like little vignettes where I'll have a mini setup, but I really like to keep the dialogue to a minute.
Right, like the door knocks and the guy's got the pizza and let's go.
You know what the scenario is and get it going.
Do you ever work with Ron Jeremy?
And you know what?
That's either a no or she's coughing out a back hair. One of the two. Look like a cat trying to get off fur
ball. And the funny thing is
I almost choked on my gum when you said that.
The reaction is always the same, no matter who comes to town. It's like he's a super nice guy, but fuck no.
Not enough money in the world.
I was being interviewed with somebody at the awards a couple of years, maybe last year or the year before, and she came up to me and she was like, oh my God, Jenna, I just before the interview, I just shot a scene with Ron Jeremy, and she was like so excited about it, and I was like,
I'm sorry.
Go brush your teeth. And I'm not working with you.
And you better connecting the dots.
Not, right. And you not matured?
That's me. I mean, he's a nice guy. He's a legend. But, I mean, no.
Who was it? Somebody was in here. Somebody in the business was here not too long ago and said that at one of the award shows or something, he was in a hotel room close to theirs, and there was just a parade of hot teenage girls going in
he
and out of his
gets
room.
Gets so much pussy. It's ridiculous. God, it's
who wanted the large sausage?
Yeah, here he is right here.
We don't have any money. How can we pay him?
Well,
there you go.
So much action. It's crazy.
Isn't that ridiculous? And he's told us before, he's like, I got into porn because that's the only way I'd ever get laid. Because he's got a big dick, but he's just butt ugly, and that's what he says.
I mean,
he says that, not me.
As ugly back in like the days,
right? Yeah. Kind of may have
let
himself go.
You think that like being on camera all the time and having sex with women all the time, you'd want to like make your body the best it could be? Because I would. I mean,
he may be naked eventually in a scene. You never know. Like, and, she's like her skin's
making me cringe.
All right, well let's do a quick guess or muff.
Okay,
and then because. Oh, it's a great website.
It's a fun game we can play with you.
Yeah, it's you have to Google the term Guess Her Muff, and then it's a website that has pictures of girls fully clothed, and then after you guess how she keeps her vagina shaved, you click a picture, and then it shows their vagina.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, goodness.
And we like the strip, yeah. Coach, what do you think?
I'm going to go hairy.
Bald.
I can't really tell.
She's bald, I guess. See, I...
What is she?
Bald.
She's looks
bald?
Like bald.
I find it unattractive when
look
a girl shaves everything.
Look at those cute little boobs, too.
Yeah. See, I kind of do, too.
Just, you know, it looks like a chicken cutlet or something, and it just...
Yeah, but it's
just
a beautiful chicken cutlet.
Yeah,
it's the best chicken cutlet ever.
I don't know. It
ever.
Makes me feel like it's like a little girl and like...
Can we ask what you got?
I have a triangle.
A triangle, okay.
I always have a triangle. Well, you know what? Actually, I've had the thumbprint, and I've had like this landing strip, but I have a triangle.
Never gone full bald because of the reason you said.
I did it once when I got molded for a toy.
Oh, that's right, and you have the fleshlight too, don't you?
Yes, I've got the mouth, the ass, and the pussy. Wow, I can say that.
Yes, you
I'm usually like trying to think of a way on radio shows where I can say that without, right. you know. I'm
it
like,
feels good, doesn't it?
I have the lips and I have, you know, both of like the bottom parts. Like, right. how do you
it's, a, it's yeah. a new member of the show. Come say whatever you want to. It's all right.
Jenna will be at Hustler Club in Washington Park, Illinois, all weekend long. Make sure you go see her 11 and 2 tonight and then Friday and Saturday as well, all weekend long.
Yeah, it's right my on. First time in the area in like 7 or 8 years.
Yes. Thank you very much for taking the time to come in
Thanks
here. We
so
much appreciate it.
If you can't see me at the club this weekend, which you should be able to make it and you don't want to miss it, you can always see me 24 hours a day on genxstudios.com or jennahaze.com. You can also follow me on Instagram at Jenna Haze or Twitter at Jenna Haze.
Right on. Thank you very much.
Awesome. Wow, she had that shit down. She's usually they're like, what's my stuff?
You've done that before.
There's so many girls like, what do I need to say? How are you doing that?
Very nice.
God. I've been doing this a long time.
Hot and a brain.
Awesome. We'll try to do it again when?
Monday.
Monday,
yeah.
Right? Monday.
Monday.
Yeah,
Monday. Sure, yeah.
Okay. Big hugs.
See you guys.
That's a wrap.
That was a good time. What was the last time you said it at the four guys in one room?
Yeah. Hey, you didn't show the Chinese hand.
Well, yeah, stay I mean,
if you want to, awesome. You don't smoke, man.
Fantastic.
Not cigarettes. No.
Right. That a girl.
Well, so, if you just liked hockey, I might ask you to marry me.
I do like hockey, but.
But no.
But.
Will you I'm get not a big sports fan. Is that okay?
Okay.
Tom,
cool.
Yeah. Coach.
I'm coming. Yeah. Oh, shit.
Get dressed and get out.
Yes, Mr. Carey. Yes, Mr. Carey.